Okay, class, good morning. So again, this is the second topic in refrigeration system. So last meeting, so we already discussed about the refrigerant used in a vapor compression system. Okay, so by this time class, we are now going to study the vapor compression cycle. Okay, so this is the second topic class. So the basic component of the vapor compression cycle or system is, of course, we have here the at the top portion we have the condenser. So meaning the condenser release the heat, of course, carried by the refrigerant coming from the compressor. So in order for the refrigerant to be liquefied, okay, so another class we have here the expansion valve. So expansion valve receives the liquid refrigerant coming from the condenser and then expanded at constant enthalpy, of course, in this expansion valve. Okay, so and then we have here the evaporator at the bottom of the of this component. Okay, so the evaporator receives the gas, of course, the refrigerant gas coming from the expansion valve. And then again, at the evaporator, heat is, of course, removed from the refrigerant or, of course, refrigerator load. Okay, so and then the heat, of course, removed from the evaporator is pumped by the compressor again in order to deliver it to the condenser. So again, the cycle will, of course, repeat and repeat and repeat. Okay, so take note class that the process involved in the cycle, we have 1 to 2. So 1 is, of course, designated in between the evaporator and the compressor. 2 is, of course, between the compressor and the condenser. 3 is between condenser and expansion valve. And 4 is between the expansion valve and the evaporator. Okay? So 1 to 2, the vapor refrigerant is compressed to a relatively high temperature and pressure. Okay? So that is class at isentropic process. Okay? At isentropic process. So meaning during compression, the process involved is isentropic. Okay? So from 2 to 3, the process involved is constant pressure. Okay? And of course, the process 2 to 4, 3 to 4 rather, is again isentropic process, so meaning constant enthalpy process. And then 4 to 1 is again constant pressure process. So that is now the processes involved in the refrigeration or the vapor compression cycle. Okay, so here is class the pH diagram or the pressure enthalpy diagram. Okay, so we have two figures here. So take note class, this pH diagram, so from 1 to 2 the work, of course, is towards the compressor. Okay, so 1 to 2, so it requires work of the compressor, which is towards the system. And then process 2 to 3, that is constant pressure. Take note, 1 to 2 class is isentropic, meaning the entropy is constant during the process. Okay, so 2 to 3 is constant pressure, and then 3 to 4 is a straight line, which is perpendicular to the enthalpy line, so that is P is equals to constant, or H rather is equals to constant, and then P is equals to constant for 4 to 1. Okay, so take note class that the heat at 4 to 1 is towards the system, and the QH at the process 2 to 3 is away from the system. Okay, so this class, the another we have here at the right portion of the slides is the of course the pressure, again pressure enthalpy diagram. Okay, so another we have here the TS diagram. Okay, so it looks like this class. Okay, so again we have here the evaporator, the condenser, a compressor and expansion valve, and the TS diagram is look like this. So take note class that 1 to 2 is a straight line class, so meaning the entropy during this process is constant. Okay, another is 2 to 3 is constant pressure line, and then 4 to 1 is constant enthalpy. What 3 to 4 rather is constant enthalpy line, is 4 to 1 is again a constant pressure line. Okay, so we have here class the assumption of the vapor refrigeration cycle. So we have one, each component is analyzed as a control volume at steady state, and then dry compression is presumed, so the refrigerant is a vapor. So the compressor operates adiabatically. Okay, no heat rejection, no heat absorbs at the compressor, of course, adiabatic. And then the refrigerant expanding through the valve undergoes a throttling process. Okay, so throttling meaning the process is at constant enthalpy. So another is kinetic and potential energy changes are ignored. So let us now class consider the evaporator of the system. Okay, so we have here numbered 4 to 1, and then Q is entering the system. Okay, so we have here the formula. So Q is equals, of course, to the change in enthalpy between the 1 and 4 rather, H sub 1 minus H sub 4 multiplied by the mass of the flowing refrigerant. Okay, so the term QN referred to as the refrigeration capacity. Take note class, that is the refrigeration capacity. So expressed in kilowatts in SI, BTU per hour in English, and so on and so forth. Okay, so a common alternate unit is the ton of refrigeration, or TOR. So equals to 200 BTU per minute, or 211 kilojoules per minute, or that is also equivalent to 3.516 kilowatts, equivalent to 12,000 BTU per hour. Okay, so that is class the conversion. How you are going to convert kilowatt to tons of refrigeration, and so on and so forth. Okay, so the refrigerating effect now class is again QA or Q1, that is equals to M H sub 1 minus H sub 4. Take note class that H sub 1 can be obtained from the given or the pressure and temperature given of the refrigerant. Okay, and H sub 4 of course is the enthalpy at condenser pressure. Okay, so take note class where M now is the refrigerant mass flow rate, H sub 1 is the enthalpy of the entering evaporator, And then enthalpy leaving evaporator, okay? So in tons of refrigeration, that is m h sub 1 minus h sub 4 divided by 3.516 kilowatt per ton, okay? So that is class, another formula. So you have to memorize class or study the principles involved in refrigeration cycle. So actually class, this is very easy, okay? So energy balance is considered, of course, at the refrigeration system, okay? So another, considering the comparator class, so take note that the process in a compressor is adiabatic. So the assumption is adiabatic. So the compressor work now is equals to the difference between the enthalpy. Of course, the higher enthalpy is at H sub 2, or the enthalpy of the gas leaving the compressor. And then H sub 1 is the enthalpy of the gas entering the compressor. So multiplied by the mass flow rate. Okay, so that is now equals to, or M is called the refrigerant mass flow rate, H sub 1 enthalpy entering compressor, H sub 2 leaving the compressor. Okay. So in the condenser class again, energy balance, the difference between the enthalpy of the entering gas at the condenser minus the enthalpy of the liquid leaving the condenser multiplied by the mass flow rate is now the heat rejected. Okay. Heat rejected. So QR is equal to M H2 minus H sub 3. Okay. Another class is at the expansion valve. Okay. So quality of plus gas during throttling. Okay. So that is now equals to H sub 4 is equals to H sub 3. Or H sub 4 equals to HF4 plus X sub 4 HFG4. Okay. That is class the assumption, okay? So again, H sub 3 enthalpy of the entering throttling device, H sub 4 leaving throttling device, HF4 is enthalpy of saturated liquid condition leaving throttling device, HFG4 is the latent heat at wet vapor conditions leaving throttling device, and X is the quality or weight of the plus gas per unit weight of the refrigerant, okay? So another class, we have the so-called the performance parameter. The first is the coefficient of performance. So where COP can be easily determined using the ratio of the refrigerating effect to the compressor work, okay? Or simply using the enthalpies H1 minus H sub 4 over H2 minus H sub 1, or simply H1 minus H sub 3, since H3 is equals to H sub 4. Okay, so H over H2 minus H sub 1. Another class is the so-called Carnot coefficient of performance. So this is class in terms only of the temperature given, the lower and the higher temperature. Okay. Again, that is the refrigerating effect over work of compression, or simply at a temperature that is T cold over T high minus T cold. Okay, take note class that the temperature at the numerator should be in absolute. Okay, should be absolute. Okay. Next. So we have the kilowatt or the power in kilowatt per ton, okay? So kilowatt per ton, that is compressor power divided by the tons of refrigeration. So volume flow rate at suction, V sub 1, equals to M V sub 1, okay? Take note class that V sub 1 or small letter V sub 1 is the specific volume of the refrigerant at point 1, okay? So take note also class of the term EER. So take note class that EER is somewhat related to the coefficient of performance. So take note class that the unit used for a EER is in BTU per watts, okay? BTU per watts, okay? So that is class European standard, okay? BTU per watts, EER, okay? So another class is the displacement rate of compressor, okay? So we have here the displacement rate, BD is equals to pi d square over 4. So that is the area of the board multiplied by the length of stroke multiplied by the number of cycles complete or cycles completed per. Okay. That is in. So take that class we have here. N is equals to N. Well, big letter N is equals to small letter N for a single acting compressor. So for double acting class, capital letter N is equals to 2 small letter N for a double acting compressor. Okay? So take note class is N is the compressor speed. Okay? So another is the actual volumetric efficiency. So that is NVA. So the volume flow rate at suction divided by the volume displacement at suction. Okay. So we have here the volumetric efficiency class, the theoretical volumetric efficiency. So that is in terms of clearance and the pressures. Okay. So the volumetric efficiency equals to 1 plus C minus C. Take note is the C is the percent clearance class. Multiplied by the ratio of the discharge pressure over the suction pressure raised to 1 over K. Okay. Or simply 1 plus C minus C multiplied by B sub 1 over B sub 2 raised to 1 over K. Okay. Another is the adiabatic compression efficiency class or isentropic work of compression over the actual work of compression. And for mechanical efficiency, that is indicated power over the brake power. So class, again, thank you very much. So the next presentation class in this topic will be the example in order for you to be familiarized, of course, in the computation of the vapor compression cycle. So thank you very much, class.